Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for joining our live stream today. I'm Katie Combs-Pritchard. I'm with the county's Health and Human Services Department. And we're here today because today is 2-1-1 day. So it's February 11th, so we're celebrating 2-1-1 on 2-11. This week, our Board of Supervisors with the county passed a proclamation declaring today, February 11th, as 2-1-1 day in Placer County. And so we decided to bring some folks together just to talk about what 2-1-1 can offer to community and to the residents. And hope you'll learn a lot today and ask your questions if you have any. So 2-1-1 has been live in Placer County for just 7 months. And essentially it's a one-stop shop for residents, for community and different social services. And then it also can provide resources during emergencies for non-emergency information. So for example, they've helped connect vulnerable residents with resources during extreme heat events this year so far, also public safety power shutoffs. And then they've of course taken over our COVID-19 hotline. So they've been fielding a lot of questions about testing, routing business complaints, and then recently answering a lot of questions about vaccines. So COVID call volume has increased a lot recently. And I'm gonna turn it over to Mary with Connecting Point, who is our 2-1-1 partner vendor, and she can share a little bit more about that and about what 2-1-1 has to offer. Mary?
Thanks so much, Katie. So folks in Placer County can connect to our 2-1-1 call center by calling 2-1-1 or 833-DIAL-2-1-1. And as Katie mentioned, we can answer lots of different kinds of questions and connect people to community resources. But lately it has been vaccines, vaccines, vaccines. That is the number one topic that our callers and the community has on their mind. Some days we've actually had quadruple the average number of calls. And so our call agents have been working very hard to ensure that we can keep our wait times low and maintain the high quality of experience that we hope that our callers can get. So I wanted to share with you today a few other ways that you can access the information that we have in the 2-1-1 database to answer your questions. We work really closely with Katie and our other county partners to ensure that we have the most up-to-date information about COVID testing and vaccines. You can go to 211placer.org and actually search through our database of resources, which includes COVID-19 information. That's maintained on a daily basis by our resource specialists. You can also text us. You can text your zip code to 898-211 to get into a real-time conversation with one of our call agents. But a very popular option has been to text Placer Vaccine, all one word, that's Placer Vaccine, to 898-211. And that will get you subscribed to our text alert system that will let you know when there's changes to vaccine eligibility and availability. We have over 22,000 subscribers in Placer County, so feel free to take advantage of that free service. 2-1-1 is available to everyone. It's always free and confidential, and we can serve you in the language of your choice. We have multiple bilingual Spanish English call agents, and we have translators at the ready to talk to you in any language that you need to. So give us a call. Thank you, Katie.
Awesome. And then because 2-1-1, one of the key functions is to connect folks to community organizations who provide service to our Placer County residents, one thing we wanted to do in the live stream today was to have you meet some of our key community partners. So just a couple representative folks from different organizations in our community who have relationships with 2-1-1, and have them talk a little bit about their services and the integration with 2-1-1. So first off, I wanted to introduce Elisa Herrera, who is from our local Latino Leadership Council, and she's gonna speak just very briefly on what LLC does in our community and how 2-1-1 can interplay with that. Elisa?
Thank you, Katie. As Katie said, I'm Elisa Herrera. I'm the executive director for the Latino Leadership Council. And our organization is the only regional nonprofit here that has a team of promotores who are basically cultural brokers, or they serve as a bridge to services between the Latino population and the providers. We helped connect people to health, education, and youth development services. And so we're very thrilled to have 211 in our community. Of course, we have a lot of monolingual Spanish-speaking populations who typically don't have access to a lot of services. And so when we heard about 211, our concern was, well, they're not going to have access because it will all be English operators. And that's not the case. The county made a commitment to be able to have bilingual staff to ensure that the bilingual staff are able to communicate with those community members who need the services. So we're thrilled that they were able to do that. We know that the staff are bilingual because we are helping and partnering with Connecting Point to ensure that the staff who are hired speak the Spanish of our community, that they will be able to be understood and that they are completely fluent in both English and Spanish. So that was a real key for us and to make sure that our community members get the services that they deserve, that people can truly communicate. And I do know that if you text a 898-211, you will get a Spanish speaking or a bilingual operator being able to answer any of the questions that you pose via text. So we're happy about that as well, because some folks might feel more comfortable with texting that. So thank you, Placer County, for bringing this service to us. And please don't hesitate to reach out to 211, who may connect you with either us or other community partners who offer those bilingual services. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Lisa. And then I'll introduce our next person, but I just wanted to also mention that we have some folks watching now, and if you have questions, go ahead and plop those in the comments or the chat, and then we can address them after we have our different partners speak. So go ahead and ask any questions you might have, and I think we might be able to respond to those when we're done introducing our various folks. The next person we're gonna have speak is Michael Lombardo, who's with the Placer County Office of Education. PCOE was really instrumental in helping us migrate a lot of the resources from the previous network of care system over to the 211 system with our friends at Connecting Point. And so they've been a really key partner and now are doing a lot of great work getting resources to students and families. So I'll turn it over to Mike now.
Well, thank you so much, Katie. It has certainly been interesting times. The 211 transition happened right as the pandemic hit. Us. And in education, we've been faced with a number of challenges. You know, we want to create healthy spaces for children, either online or in person. And that has been quite challenging, like the rest of our lives. Families needing resources, increases in domestic violence, increases in abuse, neglect, getting food insecurity, homelessness, housing, all of these are issues that have faced all our families in Placer counties. With kids spending so much time either accessing online education or in-person education in Placer County, 211 has become a big focal point for us to get resources out. Some of the things that our staff have done is we created a triage team for educators. And this triage team here at the county office uses 211 resources, either the web-based resources or telephone in all the time. We're also launching a couple projects, one called Cognito Trauma-Informed Schools, to help educators understand trauma that children have faced over the last 9 months and relate to them better, but help them access services more. And part of that is connecting to 211. And then our last big project that's launching this month through education, and 211 will be part of that, is something called Handle with Care. And it's a web-based information system where a first responder, fire, police, social services, when they encounter a child who may have faced trauma, they can send a message, an email message to the school site, letting them know that this youth may have faced trauma or an adverse event. Well, 211 will be critical. So as that student shows up at school, staff will be able to support them using 211 or other resources that the schools have. So we've been thrilled to be a partner with Connecting Point and 211 and the LLC and others in helping our community support our children and families.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Mike. And then, yeah, folks, keep if you have any comments or questions, feel free to put those in, and we'll again try to address them at the end. I'm going to next introduce Nick Gulling, who's with our local gathering in. And TGI has been involved heavily with 2-on-1, partly through coordinated entry, but then also has some other links as well. So Nick, I will turn it over to you to talk a little bit about your various programs and the link there.
Thank you so much for the opportunity, Katie. Yes, TGI does provide, basically we're the main shelter provider of emergency shelter and interim care for people experiencing homelessness here in the community. So we're very, very much as an agency interested in helping to be change agents for those who come through our doors and into our programs. But there's also a variety of other programs that are serving people either experiencing homelessness or at immediate risk of experiencing homelessness. There are victim service providers, there are specific mental health providers, substance use providers. And we all work really well and really collaboratively together here in Placer County. It's one of the greatest things about working in this community is how great everybody works together. The role of 2-on-1 with these programs is that the calling 2-on-1 acts as that coordinated entry, one door enter into these programs to get access to our emergency shelters, to get referrals, to get information. So if people are starting their beginning experience of homelessness or they have been experiencing homelessness, they're able to call 2-on-1 24/7 to be able to get those connections and the access to care in a way that we're all able to keep track of and be able to provide the quality of services that we're happy to be able to give to these folks. Additionally, there's a new program now too that is involving the Gathering In, Advocates for Mentally Ill Housing, and Volunteers of America, which is providing homeless prevention funds for households that have had their income directly adversely affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. And 2-on-1 has stepped up to be able to be the referral source for that as well. So we can get that much needed aid to families that are in need so that we can prevent someone or a family to be able fall into experiencing homelessness. So we're really excited about this partnership and just really grateful for the 2-on-1 resource in general.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Nick, and thanks to all our panelists. I know in addition to the program, Nick mentioned the 2-on-1 has also been doing eligibility screening calls for our tenant-based rental assistance program through the county, and I believe soon our emergency rental assistance program. So I'll let Mary talk a little bit about that and wrap up, and then if I see any questions, we can answer them at the end, or otherwise we'll kind of slowly fade away. Mary, do you want to talk a little bit more about that?
Absolutely. Thanks, Katie. And thanks, Nick. I know that homelessness prevention, getting ahead of that emergency shelter need is something that's top of mind for the community as well, especially in the complicated times we've lived in over the past year. So we're really excited about that new program. We've also been able to make 169 tenant-based rental assistance referrals since that program became available in Placer County, helping people who have been impacted by COVID ensure that they can keep their housing. And so that's been really important to us and our call agents. On our team call today, the call agents were just sharing that they're just so excited when they can really help our callers and connect them to the services that they know are so essential. That gives them a big boost. And so just wanted to take the opportunity to give a big shout out to all of our call agents and staff who have been pedal to the metal over the past 7 months in Placer County, as we've done wave after wave of new and interesting disasters and emergencies, from extreme heat, as Katie mentioned, to PSPS, as well as trying to keep up with all the changes regarding COVID as we get to the conclusion of this pandemic era. I know we all can't wait. So just a reminder, you can give us a call. You can find us on the web at 2-on-1placer.org. You can text your zip to 898-2-on-1 to connect live with one of our call agents in English or Spanish. But one last plug, you can sign up for vaccine updates by texting Placer Vaccine to 898-2-on-1. And we only send out that information when there's a big change. So we won't spam your cell phone. And thanks so much to all of our partners, to Elisa and Mike and Nick for joining us today. It's because of the work that you're doing that we can help serve. We're just the hub. We are getting people to our partners to consume their services. And we're very grateful for the level of collaboration we've had in Placer County. And thanks so much to the community. Hang in there, everyone.
Thank you so much, Mary. And not seeing any questions, we'll wrap up. But thank you again so much to Mary and all of our community partners who joined us today. We really appreciate it. And thank you for helping us bring awareness to this service and this accessibility point for residents.